Identify the phylum based on the given characteristics. Next, 92. They are mostly endoparasite, found in animals including human being.
Platyhelminthes.
Okay. Generally marine and mostly asymmetrical.
Porifera.
Phylum Porifera. Generally marine, mostly asymmetrical. Bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic and acylomate animal with organ level of organization.
Platyhelminthes.
Yeah, organ level of organization. Notice that is given in NCERT. Bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, acylomate animal is the one more feature to recognize it as Platyhelminthes. Acylomate and organ level. Aquatic, mostly marine, sessile or free swimming. Radially symmetrical animals.
Nidaria.
That's what I mean. Coelenterata. Okay. They may be free living, aquatic and terrestrial or parasitic on plants and animals. Free living, aquatic, terrestrial or parasitic on plants and animals. It was given in Ask Helminthes. So you didn't answer. So that means you practice. You check that in NCERT textbook. Exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic with the tissue level of organization. Exclusively marine. So by looking towards the exclusively marine, we have to, we can answer. That is, Tenophora, exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic, with tissue level of organization is there in Coelenterata also, but this word, exclusively marine. Next, 98, bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and pseudocoelomate animal.
Ascelminthes.
Yeah, pseudocoelomate animal will make us to answer it as Ascelminthes. Aquatic. Marine and fresh, water they live, are terrestrial, free living, and sometimes parasites.
Annelida.
Very good. Annelida. Triploblastic, bilaterally symmetrical, organ system grade of organization, and coelomate condition, metamerically segmented. The word makers to answer it as Annelida. Phylum Annelida. Okay, organ system level, bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, segmented, coelomate. Okay, like Annelida. Then chitinous exoskeleton. Very good. Phylum Arthropoda. Terrestrial, aquatic, marine or fresh, organ system level of organization. Bilateral symmetry, triploblastic nature, coelomate animal. Okay. Calcareous shell will make us to answer.
Mollusca.
Phylum. Mollusca. Okay. Worm-like marine animal. This word is enough to answer. Organ system level. Bilateral symmetry, triploblastic, coelomate. Very good.
Hemichordata.
Hemichordata. The word is worm-like. That meant for hemichordata. All are marine, this is enough for us, organ system level, adult with bilateral symmetry, larva with radial symmetry. Yes, Echinodermata, phylum Echinodermata. In canal system, okay, that's over, now we are moving on. In canal system, water enters through, enters into, exit through respectively. The phyla questions are over.
Ostia.
Yeah, water enters through ostia, enters into spongocoel. Yeah, exit through
osculum.
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 Exit through osculum. Okay. Lining of spongocoel is with
coenocytes.
Coenocytes. Cells of lining of spongocoel are coenocytes. The pathway of water transport in porifera is helpful in
gathering food.
Yeah, very good. Food gathering. Okay.
Food gathering.
Respiratory
renal
exchange.
Oxygen.
that gaseous exchange, respiratory exchange, and removal of wastes. Removal of wastes. Very good. Food gathering, respiratory exchange, removal of wastes. Coral of cnidarians are made of, made with. Okay.
Calcium carbonate.
Calcium carbonate. Sessile cylindrical form of cnidaria is called. Sessile cylindrical form of cnidaria is called. Polyp. Umbrella shaped free swimming form of cnidaria is called.
Medusa.
Obelia is well known for this feature. Obelia is an example for alternation of generations. What do you call that? The metagenesis, alternation of generation. The feature we say metagenesis. Type of reproduction in polyp.
Asexual.
Type of reproduction in medusa.
Sexual.
Sexual reproduction. You can see in medusa that asexually reproducing polyp. Form medusa. Medusa sexually reproduce and form polyp. We call metagenesis. Obelia is the best example for that. Digestion in Ctenophora. Extracellular or intracellular? Digestion in Ctenophora. As well as in Cnidaria also we can ask the same question. Digestion in Ctenophora and Cnidaria. Both extracellular and intracellular digestion. That in the gastrovascular cavity we call extracellular, and in the special cells the lining of the cilentiron, that nutritive muscular cells, we use it to say production of light by the organisms is called
bioluminescence.
Practice and phylum which absorb nutrients from the host directly through their parasite and phylum which absorb nutrients from the host directly through their body surface.
Platyhelminth
is okay, but what is the animal? That is tapeworm. Tinea. Tinea. Particularly tinea is doing like so, which absorb the nutrients from the body surface. Member of platyhelminth is which have high regeneration capacity. High regeneration. Very good. Planaria. Member of platyhelminthes which have high regeneration capacity. Planaria. Phylum with non-muscular complete elementary canal with well-developed muscular pharynx.
Ascihelminthes.
Yeah, very good. Ascihelminthes. Okay. Phylum with an excretory tube removes the body wastes from the body cavity through the excretory pore. Phylum with an excretory tube removes body wastes from the body cavity through the excretory pore. That same, Ascihelminthes. Phylum with body surface is distinctly marked out in segments or metameres.
Annelida.
Very good. Phylum with longitudinal and circular muscles help in locomotion.
Annelida.
Nephridia of Annelida are helpful for
excretion,
osmoregulation.
Yeah, but you should say osmoregulation first. Why? Because any excretory organ, the major function is osmoregulation followed by excretion. Not only Annelida, Nephridia, anywhere, human kidney also. We should say osmoregulation first. Okay. The phylum with the neural system consists of paired ganglia connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord.
Annelida.
Yeah, Annelida, we can say. Over 2/3 of all named species on Earth are belongs to this phylum. Yes, arthropoda. Very good. Type of circulation in arthropoda.
Open type.
Open type. Arthropoda, mollusca, echinoderm are having open type. economically important insect of phylum Arthropoda? Insects.
Aris.
Yeah. Aris. Insects, we should say, isn't it? Apis, honeybee, okay, inka?
Laxifer.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Bombyx, that silkworm. Laxifer, lac insect. Vectors of phylum Arthropoda.
Anopheles,
Culex.
Anopheles, Culex, and Aedes. Aedes aegypti. Gregarious pest of phylum Arthropoda.
Locusta.
Locusta. Living fossil of phylum Arthropoda.
Limulus.
Living fossil of phylum Arthropoda. Limulus. Body of mollusks is covered by?
Calcareous shell.
Very good. Calcareous shell. Body of mollusks is covered by calcareous. Body of mollusk is segmented or unsegmented?
Unsegmented.
Yeah, it's an unsegmented body. Body of mollusk is unsegmented. A soft and spongy layer of skin forms dash over in dash in mollusk. Should fill the
mantle.
Gaps.
Mantle.
Okay, mantle. The soft and spongy layer of skin forms mantle. Mantle over
visceral hump.
Visceral hump of the body. Most of the body is called visceral hump. Structure of mollusk, which is helpful for both respiration and excretion. That is feather-like gills. No technical name given in textbook. We call it as tinidia. The feather-like gills are responsible for both respiration and excretion in mollusca. Anterior head region of mollusks bear. Anterior head region of mollusk. Is there any special in the anterior head region? Yeah, that contain sensory tentacles. Previously a subphylum of chordata. Now the phylum of non-chordates is?
Hemichordata.
Mollusks are oviparous or viviparous? Mollusks are oviparous. System of echinoderm, helpful for locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration.
Ambulacral.
Yeah, we call it as ambulacral water vascular system. Ambulacral water vascular system. Phylum earlier considered as subphylum under phylum chordata.
Hemichordata.
Okay. Rudimentary structure of hemichordata near the collar region is? Rudimentary structure of hemichordata near the collar region is the only question we can say here from hemichordata, which is always asked. That is stomocord. That we say stomocord. Structure similar to notochord, similar to notochord in hemichordates is?
Stomachord.
Yeah, the same. What do you call? Stomachord. The space between the hump and mantle is called?
Mantle cavity.
Hump and mantle is called mantle cavity. Very good. Mantle cavity. Okay. So now here onwards, you should name the phylum based on the given characteristic feature. Name the phyla. So multiple characters are there here. Name the phyla respectively. Name the phyla respectively. Phylum features are given here. Number one. So start from canal system. Phylum.
Porifera.
Phylum. Porifera. Okay. Antennae.
Arthropoda.
Arthropoda, very good. Feather-like gills.
Mollusca.
Mollusca. Excretory system is absent. Means we should verify, we should check that in which phylum it was given specifically that excretory system is absent. That is echinodermata. Very good. Echinodermata. Next, chitinous exoskeleton.
Arthropod.
Yeah, phylum arthropoda. Chitinous exoskeleton. Hypostome. Okay, that is in Coelenterata. The medusa form is having the mouth and ventral side. We call hypostome. Circular in cross section. Circular in cross section. In which phylum? This word is mentioned that when we cut the organism, that organism will be circular in cross section.
Askelmin.
Yes, are you sure? Is it Askelmin this?
Annelida.
Yes, that is given in Annelida. Okay, that we should not go that in what manner, whether it is roundworm, so that's why. Definitely that's correct actually, but just we are following through NCERT textbook where it is given, that we have to see, that's all. Here, the NCERT book is given a small paragraph everywhere. Only a small paragraph. So that means that characters only will come in examination. So where do you find this word? That's all. Circular in cross section. Yes. Circular in cross section. Ask Helmin this. File like rasping organ.
Mollusk.
Yeah, what do you call it as?
Radula.
Radula. Proboscis.
Hemicardata.
Hemicardata. Body division of hemicardata. Proboscis, collar and trunk. Calcareous acicles. Calcareous acicles. Where do you find the calcareous acicles? Yes. Echinodermata. Then ostea. Ostea. Spongocoel. Osculum.
Porifera.
Yeah, phylum Porifera. Next, simple eye and compound eye. Simple, okay, but when we say end compound eye, that is definitely phylum arthropoda. Okay, coral formation.
Cnidaria.
Yes, phylum Coelenterata. Phylum Coelenterata, we can say. Collar.
Hemicardata.
Hemicardata. Proboscis, collar, trunk in the series, we got proboscis and also collar. Largest phylum.
Arthropoda.
Yeah, arthropoda. Largest phylum, arthropoda. Tissue level of organization with diploblastic condition. Tissue level with diploblastic condition. What do you see? Both will come. Coelenterate and tenophores. Both are having tissue level and diploblastic condition. We can say them as. Okay. Comb jellies. Okay, next. Nidocytes.
Neet.
Phylum Neetaria or Coelenterata, we can say. Next, comb jellies.
Tenophora.
Whom we call comb jellies? Tenophora. Stomocard.
Hemicardata.
Hemicardata.
Stomocard. Hemicardata. Statocyst.
Neetaria.
Actually, statocyst is a balancing organ. As I said to you, we should follow the NCERT. So, the way that statocyst is given, that is very important for us. Statocyst is a balancing organ present in most animals of invertebrata, but where it was mentioned, that is very important. It was mentioned in phylum Arthropoda. Actually, the statocyst also find in the medusa phylum Cnidaria. But it was mentioned in Arthropoda. Mantle cavity.
Mollusca.
Yeah, exclusive word for phylum Mollusca. Mouth, ventral, anus, dorsal. These kind of words, mouth, ventral, anus, dorsal.
Echinoderm.
Yeah, you'll find in Echinodermata. Mouth is ventral and anus is dorsal. You'll find in Echinodermata. Next, worm-like marine animals.
Hemichordata.
Worm-like marine animals. Hemichordata. Water vascular system.
Echinodermata.
Okay, so water vascular system. Echinodermata. Metagenesis.
Cnidaria.
Cnidaria. Okay, metameres.
Annelida.
Yeah, the word meant for annelida. That means we are writing math the followings. But our answering way of math the following is different. Just by looking one word, we have to say the another. Like that. Coenocytes.
Porifera.
Yeah, porifera. Dioecious annelids. That means unisexual annelids. Unisexual annelids is polychaetes, actually, we can say. That example we have is Neris, sandworm. Next, balancing organ. Whom we call balancing organ? Statocyst.
Statocyst.
Yeah, okay, so that is there in Arthropoda. Long trunk. So in the series, this is the third one, that hemichordata, proboscis, collar, and long trunk. Mostly endoparasites of human. Mostly endoparasites of human. Where it comes? Phylum Platyhelminthes. Okay. Spicules and spongin fibers.
Porifera.
Yeah, spongin fiber. That makes us to say porifera. Monoecious annelids. That means bisexual annelids. The remaining, what do you say? Earthworm and leeches. We can say oligochaeta and Hirudinaria. Or example wise, we can say earthworm and leeches. Okay, next. Leeches. Next, rodula.
Mollusca.
Phylum Mollusca, the rasping structure, which is a very regular and famous question. Head, thorax, and abdomen.
Arthropoda.
Arthropoda. Head, thorax, and abdomen. Spiny body. Echino. Spiny. Dermata. Derm means skin. Neris. Lateral appendages of Neris. Specially asked. Neris. Lateral appendages are particularly called parapodia. Parapodia. Next, hooks and suckers.
Platyhelminthes.
Phylum Platyhelminthes. Next, sea walnuts.
Tino.
Sea walnuts are comb jellies, the Tinophora. Asexual reproduction in the form of fragmentation. Asexual reproduction in the form of fragmentation. Where do you found this word asexual reproduction
Porifera.
In the form of fragmentation?
Porifera.
Are you sure it is in phylum Porifera?
Tania.
Asexual yes. reproduction in the form of fragmentation. Fragmentation is an asexual reproduction method which is found in most animals. But the, now the question raises here, where it was given? It was given in phylum Porifera. That means in phylum Platyhelminthes, turbellarians are also go for fragmentation, but not mentioned for us. Alternation of generations, metagenesis.
Cnidaria.
Mouth lower, anus upper.
Echinoderm.
Yeah, the earlier, whatever we said, dorsal and ventral case, that in other words. Okay. Next, second largest phylum.
Mollusca.
Mollusca. Proboscis gland.
Hemichordata.
Female is longer than male.
Aschelminthes.
Yeah, Aschelminthes. Female is longer than male. Aschelminthes. Malpighian tubule.
Arthropoda.
Okay. Bioluminescence.
Dinosaur.
Yeah, here it was the same one. The bioluminescence is there in most categories of animal kingdom, but it was mentioned for us in Tinophora. That means in phylum Arthropoda, in some insects are also having the bioluminescence. That we can see some Urocardata, Pyrosoma animal, that also exhibit bioluminescence. That is additional knowledge. We just answer, need to answer based on NCRT. Okay, nidoblast cells.
Nidaria.
Yeah, cylinderata, nidaria. Collar cells.
Hemichordata.
Flame cells. Flame cell. The excretory cells of phylum Platyhelminthes. Head muscular foot visceral hump.
Mollusca.
Phylum Mollusca. Next, dorsoventrally flattened body. This word meant for phylum Platyhelminthes. Medusa.
Cylinderata.
Okay, locomotion, capture, transport of food and respiration.
No,
just see once. Locomotion, capture, transport of food and respiration. What is that exactly?
Water
vascular system. Now you answer. That is water vascular system, and that is belongs to Echinodermata. Very good. Water vascular system, Echinodermata. We can see. Next, annules. Annules means rings, and that means it is phylum Annelida. Osculum.
Phylum
Porifera. Next, Parapodia.
Annelida.
Yes, Annelida. Polyp.
Cylinderata.
Polyp, cylinderata. Sponge seal.
Porifera.
Sponge seal, phylum Porifera. Part of canal system. Phyla with direct development. Actually, you should fill that individual phyla with that particular development is direct or indirect. In that way, we have to go. Then let's come. Let's start discussion on this particular area. Phyla with direct development. So we should answer all the phyla. Direct development means without larval form. Okay. So let me take from the phylum onwards. How to fill this that we have to go. Phylum onwards. So I am talking about phylum Porifera. You should say phylum Porifera is having in which category it will come. Direct development or indirect development?
Indirect.
Indirect development. So we'll write here. Phylum Porifera is with indirect development. Okay. Next, phylum Cylinderata. What is given in phylum Cylinderata? Direct or indirect? Development in phylum Cylinderata is given as direct or indirect? There is a larval form called planula. In case of phylum Cylinderata, there is a larval form called planula, not mentioned in the text, but just for filling the gaps, we have to move through that Cylinderata. Okay. Next, Tenophora. Tenophora is having direct development or indirect development?
Indirect
development. That larval form is called Cydippid, not mentioned in the text, but larva is there, Cydippid. Okay. Next, phylum Platyhelminthes, direct or indirect?
Indirect.
That indirect development. We'll find so many larval forms like our tapeworm is having cysticercus larva. Fasciola is having series of larval form. Miracidium, sporosis, radia, sarcaria, metasarcaria. Okay, next. Phylum Aschelminthes. Direct or indirect? It was mentioned in the textbook actually. Development may be direct or indirect. It was mentioned. When it comes to the Platyhelminthes, we are not mentioned. That's why we took the liberty. But larval form is almost there for all. So it was mentioned here. Aschelminthes is having direct development and also indirect development. Some of them are having direct development and some of them are having indirect development. Ascaris is having a larval form, Rhabdidae form. Ocararia is having a larval form. That microphylaria larva. Likewise, Ankylostoma is having strungyli form larva. They're all indirect development. Most free living of Aschelminthes are having direct development. Okay, next. Phylum Annelida should come under direct development or indirect development. Here also, not mentioned actually. Not mentioned. When it comes to the Neris, that is having indirect development. Trochophore larva is there in the Neris. So I am writing in both places. Annelida, in bracket I am putting here, in bracket. So just I said to you, not mentioned in the text in CRT, but just filling gaps we are making. Polychaeta is having a larval form. Okay, but direct development is there in Annelida in the remaining. That means earthworms and leeches, Oligochaeta and Hirudinea. Oligochaeta and Hirudinea, these two classes are with direct development. Moving on to the phylum Arthropoda. Phylum Arthropoda. Here also we can say, we'll fill the two, direct development. If you take our cockroach, direct development is there. And if you take mosquito, there is a larval form. It was mentioned in the text actually. It was mentioned that mosquito, a larval form is mosquito, wriggler, the indirect development, housefly, maggot, likewise. Okay, next, phylum Mollusca. Coming to the phylum Mollusca.
Indirect.
Yeah, it was specifically indirect. Mentioned. Here there are so many larval forms in phylum Mollusca. That trochophore, veliger, glaucidium are the various kinds of larval forms. Okay, next, Echinodermata. This is what we can say, exclusive indirect development. Echinodermata is having indirect development, we can see. That so many larval forms are there, bipinnaria, bracularia, ophiofluteus, echinofluteus, likewise. Next, Eurocardata. We can say Eurocardata indirect development. Indirect development in Eurocardata. Okay. So there is indirect development in Eurocardata. Cephalocardata. Development is direct or indirect? Here even, I am taking a little freedom here. I am writing cephalocardata, indirect development. Okay. Next, the cyclostomata.
Indirect.
Yeah. That in case of petromyjan, we have an evidence here. That petromyjan is having indirect development. But myxin is having direct development. That's the issue. Okay, cyclostomata, I am writing in bracket, petromyjan, because it was mentioned the larval form, a moose eat larva, we use it to say. Next, chondrichthyes, development is direct or indirect? Is there any larval form there? Chondrichthyes, fish we are asking. It is having direct development. Chondrichthyes is having direct development. We can see direct development. That viviparous and osteichthyes. Even there is no larval form in the osteichthyes. So direct development. Direct development. Okay. So next, In the same way, amphibia, direct or indirect?
Indirect.
It was mentioned in the textbook. That is, indirect development is there in amphibia. Larval form, we know the well-known tadpole larva. Reptilia, development is direct or indirect? In case of reptilia, undoubtedly the development is
direct.
Okay, direct development is there in reptilia. Aves, direct development, no doubt about that. Mammalia, direct development. So this is the list. This is the list with direct development and indirect development. So I request all of you to do the same with the remaining also. Phyla with asexual reproduction, phyla with only sexual reproduction, phyla with external fertilization, phyla with internal fertilization. It is just to make you to notice that particular characters of the textbook. I am not asking you to go for invertebrate zoology, RL, Kotpal and write all the information. We are not asking like that. Just we are asking questions that notice the questions from NCERT textbook, which is given in that manner. Okay. So I am moving here. Animals belonging to phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by the presence of a
motor.
Presence of a chordate characteristic features, we are asking. Presence of a notochord and pharyngeal gill slits. Pharyngeal gill slits. And dorsal tubular neocord. Dorsal tubular neocord. Okay. So a characteristic characterized by the presence of a notochord and a dorsal tubular neocord and a paired pharyngeal gill slits, we should answer it as that chordate characteristic features we are asking. Or else we can say the post anal tail is also one of the chordate characteristic feature, the post anal tail. Okay, moving on. Type of symmetry, number of germ layers, primary chordate characters. You are asking here the type of symmetry, number of germ layers, type of body cavity, one after another. Type of symmetry.
Bilateral
symmetry. Type of symmetry, bilateral. Type of body cavity.
Secondary body
card. Eucilomate, we can say. Particularly enterocilomate. Eucilomate, we can say. Okay, eucilomate. Next, type of number of germ layers.
Three
germ layers. Triploblastic condition. Eucilomate condition. Next, type of organization.
Organ system grade of organization.
Type of organization, type of circulatory system. Mostly closed, open or closed, we'll say, but mostly closed vascular system is present here, except Eurochordata. Open vascular system is there in Eurochordata. Position of tail in Chordata. We call it as post anal tail. Post anal tail, that means posterior to the anus. Condition of chordate, condition of notochord in chordates and in non-chordates. Okay, condition of notochord in chordates and in non-chordates. This is the question actually. Simply we answer present, absent. Condition of central nervous system in chordates. Condition of central nervous system. That means here the questions are framed based on the box table which is present. Condition of the central nervous system in chordates. That is dorsal, hollow and single. Condition of central nervous system in non-chordates. Ventral, solid and double. Ventral, solid and double. ఏమైందిరా ఆన్సర్ చెయ్యట్లేదు ఎగ్జాస్ట్ అయిపోయారా సరే మనం జస్ట్ వి హావ్ ఇంకా 255 క్వశ్చన్స్ అండి ఇది ద డిఫరెంట్ థింగ్ మళ్ళీ డిఫరెంట్ ప్యాటర్న్స్ లో ఆస్క్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆస్క్ హియర్ గ్యారంటీగా చెప్తున్నాను ఈ 255 క్వశ్చన్స్ ఈ ఫ్రేమ్ కంప్లీట్ చేస్తే మనం విఆర్ ఏబుల్ మనకి ఫ్యూచర్ రివిజన్స్ కూడా 1-1.5 hours లో అయిపోతాయండి అంటే మనకి ఏం తెలుసు ఏం తెలీదో తెలిసిపోతుంది బేసిక్ ప్రాబ్లం ఎనిమల్ కింగ్డమ్ లో బేసిక్ ప్రాబ్లం ఏంటంటే వాట్ యు నో వాట్ యు డోంట్ నో తెలియక టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ మొదటి నుంచి చివరి దాకా చదువుతారండి అట్లా ఇక్కడ మనకి చూడగానే తెలిసిపోతుంది మీ ఆన్సరింగ్ మోడ్ లో కూడా కొన్ని వెంటనే చెప్పాం కొన్ని లేట్ గా చెప్పాం కొన్ని చెప్పలేదు చెప్పని తక్కువ ఉన్నాయిలేండి ఓకే సో అట్లీస్ట్ సమ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ ఆన్సరింగ్ చలో అంటే ఇక్కడ ఈ ఈ పేపర్ ప్రాక్టీస్ చేస్తే దట్స్ ఎనఫ్ మనం ఆ పర్టికులర్ క్వశ్చన్ పాకెట్ లో వేసుకున్నట్టే అమ్మ ఇంత కష్టపడాలా రెండు క్వశ్చన్ల కంటే అలా ఒక్కొక్క చాప్టర్ పేర్చుకుంటూ పోతేనే మనం అంటే ఈ వీక్ లో మనం ఏం చేస్తున్నాం వేరే అర్జెంట్ పనులు ఏమైనా ఉన్నాయా ఏం లేవు కదా సో ఈ వీక్ లో ఈ ప్రాక్టీస్ కంటిన్యూస్ గా చేస్తే ఇఫ్ యు డూ దిస్ ప్రాక్టీస్ కంటిన్యూస్లీ విల్ మేక్ అస్ టు గెట్ పర్ఫెక్షన్ మళ్ళీ ఫ్యూచర్ రివిజన్స్ లో చాలా తక్కువ టైం పడుతుంది అట్లా అండ్ మీకు ముందే చెప్పా హ్యూమన్ ఫిజియాలజీ పెద్ద ప్రిపరేషన్ అక్కర్లా మనం క్వశ్చన్స్ ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయాలి ఒక 100-200 క్వశ్చన్లు ప్రాక్టీస్ చేస్తే మైండ్ లో సబ్ కాన్షియస్ ఫీడింగ్ జరుగుతుంది అనమాట అట్లా ఇక్కడ క్వశ్చన్స్ కాదు అసలు క్వశ్చన్స్ కన్నా ముందు మనకు తెలియాల్సింది ఏంటంటే చూసి గుర్తుపడాలి అదేంటి అని కెనాల్ సిస్టమ్ గుర్తుపడుతున్నాం వాటర్ వాస్కులర్ సిస్టమ్ గుర్తుపడుతున్నాం ఇంకేమైనా గుర్తుపట్టట్లేదా అలా చూసుకోవాలన్నమాట ఇందాక ఫ్లేమ్ సెల్ కి ఆన్సర్ రాలే అట్లా ఫ్లేమ్ సెల్ రాకపోవడం ఏంటి ఒకసారి ప్లాటీ ఎలిమెంటిస్ అని బయోలుమినిసెన్స్ అట్లా అంటే మైండ్ లో ఉన్న పాత నాలెడ్జ్ అంతా మర్చిపోయి ఎన్సీఆర్టీ నాలెడ్జ్ ఫెడప్ చేయాలి అంటే ఈ క్వశ్చన్స్ కి ఆన్సర్ అలా చేయాలి ఓకేనా సరే విల్ కంటిన్యూ దిస్ ఇన్ నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్